If you have not heard about this case, please prepare yourself for a roller coaster of emotions, being disappointed by the child welfare system, and just two parents that were scums and low lives. Now, this video will send you down a roller coaster of emotions, and before I get into it, I would like to give a disclaimer that this video is for educational purposes only, and this video will include very disturbing pictures. So please just be warned, if you are very sensitive to topics about children, this may not be the video for you, but I do recommend that you check out my other videos on this channel. Now, this precious baby boy right here was 7-year-old Adrian Jones. Adrian Jones was one of those kids who just walked into a room and would light it all up. And if you were feeling down, he would be there to put a smile on your face. He was just overall just a precious, sweet, and very, very handsome little boy. Adrian lived with his father, Michael Jones, and his stepmother, Heather Jones. They did have 6 children, but for some reason, they singled out Adrian and abused him gruesomely. Now, with these tortures, Heather and Michael did decide for some reason to put cameras everywhere so that they can document the tortures that they put on this baby boy. Now, these pictures and videos that they would take would come and bite them in the butt, because this was used as evidence against them in the future. Now, just a little fast forward, when Heather was awaiting her trial, she did miss her kids and had pictures of her other 5 kids of the 6, and so she gave her passwords and her logins to her landlord so that her landlords can like print some photos out for her so she can look at those photos while she awaited her trial. And this is when the landlord saw all the evidence of the abuse that was put on baby boy Adrian. I will be going down a list of the pictures as well as what Adrian went through. Now, there was video evidence of this baby boy shivering as he stood outside in the freezing cold. This was around January, and I don't know about you, but it is very cold in Kansas around this month. And this boy was set outside, shackled in his feet and on his hands. This picture right here is one that really breaks my heart, as this is a picture of Adrian being left overnight in the freezing, dirty, filthy swimming pool of their home. His ankles were shackled in the pool, and this is a picture of his ankles. They were very swollen as a result of this torture. Now, on days that these scums decided that it was necessary for Adrian to be indoors and for him to enjoy a good night's sleep, they did bring him in. They would blindfold this baby boy, and they would put him on an inversion table where he would spend the night. There were times where this precious baby would try to drink out of a cup, however, he could not do so as his wrists were handcuffed behind his back. And this picture right here shows cutting boards that were bound around Adrian's body, and this is because Heather and Michael did not want him to ever bend over. And this is a close-up of Adrian's lips that were covered with sores. Now, these sores were caused because he was trying to chew at a plywood that was placed in his mouth as a form of torture. And in this picture, Heather can be seen taking selfies of herself right in front of the shower where Adrian was confined. Adrian was made to carry tiki torches and made to walk around aimlessly in a video that was taken by his twisted father and his pathetic stepmother. Now, Heather and Michael would put alarm systems in the fridge, and this is because they wanted to make sure that Adrian was not sneaking in food, and that if he did ever try to sneak in food, that the alarms will ring and they would torture him more. Now, the torture did not stop there. These parents would prop Adrian by the table, put a hot plate right by him that he could not touch, and even if he wanted to eat it, he could not, as they would shove soap down his throat to prevent him from even trying to get a little bit of crumbs into his mouth. It was reported that at one point, Michael jabbed Adrian with a broomstick, which left Adrian with a deep scar on his face. Now, what really grinds my gears and really just makes me feel unsettled is that the child welfare system knew that Adrian was being abused, but they did absolutely nothing. Instead, in 2012, the Kansas Department for Children and Families removed Adrian from his biological mother and gave him to his abuser and father, Michael. In 2012, a Missouri Children's Division social worker and police officer actually spoke with Adrian. Now, this little baby boy told him that his father kicks him, continuously hits him in the head, and punches him in the stomach. He also told them that both his father and his mom, and this really breaks my heart because although he endured such torture, he still addressed Heather as mother. And Heather never addressed Adrian by his name or baby boy. She always addressed this baby by the boy. Adrian told them that he was always locked up in his room without a pillow and without a blanket. There were reports that the Missouri Children's Division found evidence that Adrian had been neglected in July of 2013. The crazy thing is, Heather and Michael tried to give Adrian to the authorities, but for some reason, the authorities did not want to take him. The family stopped communicating with Missouri authorities and moved out of state to Kansas. However, for those of you who live in Kansas or Missouri, you know that Kansas City lies directly on the border between the two states. According to reports, a Missouri caseworker said they were made aware that Adrian had disclosed physical abuse by his stepmother Heather Jones and his father Michael Jones during an interview held in Missouri. The workers said that they reported that the children are homeschooled and not seen by any outside members of a family on a regular basis, which heightened their concerns for the safety of the children. Now, because Adrian's family would bounce back and forth between Kansas and Missouri, the child welfare system said that this has made very difficult for them to look into what really goes on in their household. They also said that they thoroughly investigated each reported incident of abuse or neglect involving Adrian. And my thing is, if y'all thoroughly investigated what was going on with this baby boy, then why did y'all not just take him out of the household? They say all this, but at the same time, didn't y'all just say that the last contact y'all had with him was 2012? So which one is it? Have you ever noticed that whenever something horrible happens, people see it and they just turn their heads like nothing ever happened? Well, this is exactly what happened in this case. A former employee of Michael Jones stated that he saw the abuse happening to Adrian, yet he said nothing. How can you see a child being abused and say absolutely nothing? Now, Heather Jones was extremely pathetic. She shared pictures of Adrian to her groups over Facebook, and she also discussed and shared stories of torturing young Adrian. And even though she shared these to her groups on her Facebook, and I don't know who in their sick, twisted mind was watching this and being like, okay, because none of them in that Facebook group said anything about the torture that Adrian was going through. During his final days in fall 2015, the young boy was trapped in a white tiled shower, as y'all can see in this picture, and he was left to die. And essentially, Adrian died of starvation. Now really brace yourself for what I'm about to tell you right now. Adrian's father, Michael, told authorities that after Adrian was left in the bathtub for 2 weeks, this boy was left in the bathtub for nearly 2 weeks, Michael went and purchased pigs. And I'm sure I don't even need to say it. You guys already know what happened to baby boy Adrian. Yes, this boy was fed to the pigs. The family had a livestock pen on their property, and this is where Adrian's remains were found. Now, before Adrian's death, a child told investigators that he could hear him screaming that he was going to die. And through a vent, Heather's pathetic voice could be heard telling Adrian to suck it up. Michael and Heather both pleaded guilty to first-degree murder, and they were sentenced to life in prison. My hope is that anyone who sees this video, please share it with everybody that you know. And never let the child welfare system forget what happened to this precious baby boy, Adrian Jones.